Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's talk about carbanions as reaction intermediates in organic chemistry. So, top of the screen has four different carbanions. The trends for carbanions are very similar to carbocations, except for they're exactly the opposite. And naming carbanions or referring to the carbanions also follows carbocation trends. So, in this structure here, we have a carbon with a negative charge with one attached carbon group, that's a primary carbanion. Once we get two carbon groups, it's secondary. Once we have three, it is tertiary. Sometimes we write 1, 2, or 3 degrees. And then again, I don't like it, but we call it with zero carbon groups. We call it a methyl carbanion, and it doesn't get its own special degree label like the others. Now, stability-wise, in carbocations, less substitution results in less stability. Through hyperconjugation, let's just write hyperconjugation, keep it short. Through hyperconjugation, these attached carbon groups feed in electron density. That feeding of electron density is good for a carbocation that has a positive charge. It's bad news for a negative charge. So these carbanions get less stable as we go across this row. And that makes the methyl carbanion more stable. So hyperconjugation is important. It's important in the opposite way. We also could talk about resonance with carbanions. As always, when in resonance, we start with where the electrons are. So we're going to move this carbanion, this lone pair. We're going to make a new carbon-carbon pi bond. This carbon already has four bonds. We'll have to break an old bond. Those electrons go to that carbon. Let's draw this resonance form. So we'll have a double bond on the right. And on the left, we'll have the carbon with a lone pair. When evaluating these two resonance forms, we'd say, well, this carbanion is a secondary carbanion, and this carbanion is a primary carbanion because there's only one carbon attached to the negatively charged carbon. Therefore, we'd say, since this is primary on the left, we'd say this is more stable, or this is the major contributor, and this would be the minor contributor on the right. So that's how we think about resonance in carbanions. We can also talk about inductive effects with carbanions. So here we have a tertiary carbanion, not very stable. This is also a tertiary carbanion. But for the right-hand structure, we changed the carbon to a fluorine. That gives rise to a polarized carbon-fluorine sigma bond. That fluorine is going to bear some negative charge, a partial negative charge. This carbon is going to be partial plus. That partial plus next to the carbanion is a stabilizing effect. So we'd say the right-hand structure is actually more stable because of the inductive effect. So we can talk about hyperconjugation, resonance, and induction with carbanions exactly the same way we consider it with carbocations. The outcomes are different, but it's still applying these ideas to stabilization of charge.